Well, today the next lot of GDP figures came out, which show, I think, what everyone knows, and that's the economy's had a pretty tough 6 months. And the next few months, the next year is going to be fairly tough as well, with further contraction in the economy. It's about, the numbers are about in line with what Treasury forecast in the budget. And it fits in a context where most of the commentary is along the lines that the global recession has at least flattened out, that we might be somewhere near the bottom. So that makes our plan about the road to recovery, I think, much increasingly relevant and urgent. In the budget, National kept its election commitments, got on top of debt, locked in support for entitlements through the bottom of the recession. But now we've got to get off down the road to recovery to get the economy in shape so that it will generate new jobs as we come out. Now, there's going to be a few challenges there for the country, for the government, and for the individuals who want to get their jobs back. The first one is just that the government's books are significantly out of whack. Now, the budget forecasts 10 years of deficits. There's different ways of calculating that deficit, but they all indicate that we've got a pretty long, hard slog to get back to surplus, and we want to get back to surplus so that we can have some choices about, you know, better services, more services, saving more in the super fund. And we're working pretty hard now on how we're going to lift public sector performance to see if we can do better than that 10-year slog. The other imbalance is about the tradables and the non-tradable sector, the tradable sector being exports, tourism, domestic activity that's exposed to international competition. It's been in recession for 5 years, and the current conditions are pretty tough. Figures today show manufacturing shrinking by 7%. So there's a growing realisation, certainly in the government, and I think in there will be in the public, that too much of the growth and the jobs of recent years was based on big government spending and too much borrowing. And so as soon as the borrowing has slowed down and government spending has slowed down, those jobs are disappearing. And that's very tough on people facing the stresses of losing their jobs and the uncertainty for them and their families. The lesson is that in the next 5 or 10 years, we must build those jobs on sustainable competitive advantage in New Zealand and on exports and investment, not on borrowing and government spending. That's going to be quite a difficult shift to execute, but we're up for that challenge. We're on the road to recovery. The economy is going to pick up, and so the basics of the program at the moment are getting on with what's a multi-billion dollar investment and infrastructure, particularly energy and roads, which are the biggest bottlenecks in the economy, lifting public sector productivity, because that's 25% of the economy that's been lagging. We want to clean up all the red tape that's been holding back business over recent years. It's going to matter a lot now to get businesses confident enough to invest, because that's when they employ someone, and that's when unemployment goes down. If they're not investing, there won't be new jobs because we can't finance them in the future out of excessive borrowing. We're also going to be focusing the next 12 months on education and skills, particularly for our young people who run the risk of being locked out of the workforce. There's been a bit of early public discussion about tax and whether we've got the most efficient tax system, the simplest tax system that we can have, so it's not holding back people's initiative and enterprise. So we're looking forward to cracking on with a program that's some of which is well underway, but there's a lot more to come, and we're looking for a lot more debate about the choices that New Zealand faces to lift our economic performance.